Welcome back to ECW. We're back, and Kenen Shi, as a return of the women's champ, she is back from a long trip in Japan, and she did a cover of the photo shoot for Pokemax magazine on DeviantArt. We'll check it out. It hasn't been posted yet, but once we do, she was actually the cover of December, and really this was probably the best of 2020, and you know, we had some of the best of 2020, so it's just Mugen actually having collaborating with Pokemax magazine. It has been a great role. Of course, Daisy May has been doing a great job as being the director of the magazine cover, and Kenen Shi was on the cover for December. She looked fantastic as a new champion, looking pretty good, and she's been rolling right now. She's a very highly popular diva. But right now, who's the spot, you may ask, and this is an open challenge. Bob and Shantae returned on Extreme Saturday, returned to ECW for that Mugen draft this past January. I gotta say, Shantae, I never seen Shantae look better. And of course, ever since leaving Raw to ECW, now this is a big opportunity for her to hopefully, because she's a former women's champ too. And Shantae making a nice return here too. And it's just hard to see her, you know, lose like that. And of course, I know this is a new version. I'm sorry, Roy. If you watch this video, yeah, sorry, Roy. I think we have a new Shantae, which has been updated in like what, since 2018. I know he's working hard on Shantae, but obviously, I found a new version. Let's see. Actually, she looks pretty powerful though. She had a good matchup too on Extreme Saturday. So let's see if she can do can rejuvenate herself into women's top. She actually's like the only out of all the divas right now on the roster. I think either Mal, Ayane, Black Queen, Irie, Cammy, and Chun-Li herself could be a potential for the women's championship. But Shantae is one of those divas who could do it, actually. After feuding with Kenen Shi, actually, she stole the title from Kenen Shi back in the day. Because those two were having a little dance-off. Kind of a funny moment, too. But yeah, this is an open challenge. Is it going to be worth it? Will Shantae redeem herself, actually pin the women's champ for the first time in a while? And ever since when the damn thing? Half genie, half human being, we're gonna find out right here. It's Kenen Shi for the first time, she has not defended a women's title yet, but a win over the champ could be a huge. This is a non-title match. As the hill would start first ball the deal for Shantae. And this would be a big win. I know Kenen Shi has not been in action in the last few months. Let's see how it goes. And Shantae again, some good hair whips to start off. Fireballs! Is she trying to avoid it? Fireball, nope, miss! Again, both ladies, some good evasive. Like, ooh, triple dragon punch. Nice move by Kenen Shi. Looking about a champion herself. As a new model, looking fantastic. As her new cover's coming out. Hopefully, if it came out in December, but it probably won't be around until this December, at least. That's what I'm afraid. Ooh, good dodge. A lot of misses for both divas here. Ooh, and looks like they'll study Kenen Shi now. This will be an opening that Shantae needs here. And I guess Kenen Shi stuck. You want to do something, Shantae? Okay. Kenen Shi, you're good? I didn't even compete in a while, but seriously, you're showing some ring rust there, honey. Sweet lord. Alright, let's control. Meanwhile, with this, looks like Kenen Shi has her second with triple dragon punch and stunning the returning Shantae. And the champion with a nice little workout. I mean, besides the glitchiness, just stunning Kenen Shi for a second there. And here comes round two. And Shantae's trying to step up and some of her game here. Oh, nice little big drill. Is your hair whip nice move? Kenichi again, nice shoulder-to-shoulder block. Good tech bonus there by Kenichi. And now Shantae relying on those hair whips. Good dodge again, Shantae going with those hair whips again. And then normally Kenichi usually using her popping the cherry, which is one of her signature moves. Right now, Shantae trying to bring it to the champion here tonight. Yeah, Shantae trying to force a three here. Trying to contest it. Some good strings here, some good combos here by Kenen Shi. And the champion's got a big finisher coming up. Oh, and a big high kick off the midsection. And oh my god, what, Shanti just got deleted. Jesus. And there you go, the women's champion. I mean, good effort by Shanti. Those hair whips are really, really lethal. I think she became Bianca Belair for a second. but yeah, that's really, that's a pretty lethal. That hair whip is pretty lethal. If she had longer extensions, that would have been pretty funny. Just pull up the extensions, just whips get into you with it, like Bianca Belair does. Oh man, that would be really funny though. But yeah, awesome matchup. Is the women's champ returning with a little bit of ring rust, but Kenichi returns with a nice vengeance here and returns to ECW for the first time since January. I believe it was January or probably December. But she was away for a while. Let's just say she was away for a while, but then she's still showing why she's still got it. She's a Hall of Famer for a reason, as the HOFer takes an open challenge, and no title matches for Shante, sadly. Now back to losing again. Yeah, she was on a losing streak on Raw, when she was on Raw back early January, until she got drafted. But 2-0 nonetheless, enough said.